In this video, you will learn how to remotely access a Windows computer from an iPad without opening any ports to the internet. Before you begin, you will need to create a remote account at the remote website, install remote on both devices, install an RDP client on the iPad. In this tutorial, I will be using Microsoft Remote Desktop. And both devices must be on, awake, and connected to their respective networks. If you need help with any of this, please refer to the information in the description box below. The methods presented in this tutorial can only be used if the target Windows computer supports Remote Desktop. This includes additions such as Windows 10 Pro and Enterprise. In the case that your target Windows computer does not support RDP, you will need to use another remote connection software such as VNC. In order to remotely access a Windows device, you will need to set the RDP remote access permissions on the device you would like to connect to. In this case, the computer I want to connect to is running on Windows 10 Pro. Start by opening the control panel. Click on System and Security. Then find System and click on Allow Remote Access. This System Properties dialog will appear. Under Remote Desktop, select Allow Remote Connections to this computer. This dialog will appear if your computer is set to go to sleep while not in use. Your computer must be awake to connect to it remotely, so to change the setting, click on Power Options. This dialog will appear. Next to Balanced, click Change Plan Settings. Next to Put the Computer to Sleep, in the drop-down menu, select Never. Then click Save Changes. Now I can close both of these windows and click OK. Confirm this box is checked so the computer will only allow connections from authenticated computers. Then click the OK button to save these settings. RDP has now been enabled on the device. Open the Remote Desktop app on the target Windows device. Sign into your Remote account. Then click Sign In. In the Devices tab, click the Setup button. You'll be brought to this menu. By default, the device in your Remote account will be given the same name as your PC, but you could also change this name. In this case, I'm just going to use the default. Under Services, you will see these four Quick Add services. For the purposes of this tutorial, you will only need the Windows RDP service and the Remote Admin Panel service, so you can uncheck these other two services. The Windows RDP service is what you will use to remotely connect to this computer, and the Remote Admin Panel service will allow you to remotely add more services to this computer later. Note that both of these services are not opening these ports to the internet. They will only be accessible from your remote account. Then click the blue register button. This registration process may take a few minutes. When the green checkmark appears, the registration process for the device is complete. Now you're ready to connect remotely. To ensure RDP is working properly, before connecting remotely over the internet, we recommend first checking that you can connect over your local network. That way, if you do run into an issue, you'll be able to troubleshoot on the target device. Okay, now I'm on an iPad. As you can see, I've already downloaded both a remote app and an RDP client application. As a reminder, I'm using Microsoft Remote Desktop. So you're going to open the remote app and sign in with the same remote credentials you used earlier. Then click Sign In. In your device list, you will see your target Windows device. Click on the device. You will see the two services you registered earlier. You will be connecting with the Windows RDP service. So click on the service, and you'll be brought to this screen. Then click on Connection Handler, and make sure that Remote Desktop Client is selected. This will allow the remote app to auto-launch the connection in the RDP client application. So then you're just going to click this connect button at the bottom. And when the connection has been made, the screen will look like this. This will turn blue, and this will be grayed out. This is the address you will use to connect to the Windows device. This is a proxy address, meaning that by using it, your connection will pass through the remote cloud before reaching the Windows computer. If you want to learn more about proxy connections, I'll leave some information in the description box below. Next, you're going to click on this arrow in the upper right-hand corner to launch the connection in the RDP client application. The RDP client application will open. Enter the credentials of the computer you are connecting to. Then click Continue. Your Windows desktop will open, and you can use it as usual. As you can see, the remote app is still open. I can close that. And just to show responsiveness, I'll open a web browser. To stop the connection, click on this middle button at the top, then click the home icon in the upper left-hand corner, close the RDP client app, and reopen the remote app. From the screen of the RDP service, press close connection. When the screen looks like this again, the RDP service has been disconnected. For additional information, visit our website, or contact support at remote.it. Thanks for watching.